Dancing on the edge of every cliff. From which I fell. But it's always been this way.
Well, hello and welcome to the Cotswolds. Today you join me on a beautiful new syndicate called Blue Water. My name's Otto Reade, and for those who don't know me already, I've been a mad keen angler for around a decade now. This piece is a season on a syndicate, so you'll join me on this beautiful new place for this season, and hopefully more ups and downs, but I'll take you through absolutely everything that happens on here, my journey on this lake. I cannot wait to get started. I got the ticket about 2 weeks ago, or I knew of that I was gonna get the ticket about 2 weeks ago. So I've been doing my prep work. I've been on Google Maps looking at all the bays, and I'm finally here, and what a place it is. It's the beginning of spring at the moment. The trees are just coming into life. The daffodils are up, and it does look good for a fish or two. But who knows, it's still early in the year. I've got the whole year ahead of me. Well, that's enough of me waffling on. I'm sure there is going to be quite a bit of that throughout this series. For now, sit back, relax, and welcome to a season on the Syndicate. So here you join me at home, and this is really where the story begins. I've just got news that I'll be able to join a new ticket in the Cotswolds this spring, and I honestly am absolutely over the moon. It kind of came out of the blue, to be honest. I had a couple of conversations with people about it, but I'm here and it's just come through, and you can probably tell I'm shaking a little bit because I am so excited. But a little more about me. I'm trying to look for my Bombay mix because I can't function without it. So let me just go and get that, and then I'll be back. Right, got my Bombay mix. Anyone who knows me very well knows that I absolutely love Bombay mix. And if you're ever out there on the bank, got some Bombay mix free, and see me, forget the cups of teas. I'll be straight in for that. But that is besides the point, because yeah, you can probably tell I'm absolutely buzzing to get up there. I've never really fished syndicates before. Very different to what I'm used to. So yeah, I cannot wait to get up there and document it all for you. But I could go now, really. One, except for my schoolwork, because I am still in school. So my time on the bank is very limited to weekends. And I don't go every weekend because I've been a bit of a muppet and failed my theory test for my driving license. So yeah, I have to wait another couple of months now until I can get the next one. And then try and get a test to pass. So I have to get my parents to drop me up there. And I'm sure you'll probably have a little chuckle to yourself because you probably all can drive, except from the younger people that are watching this. But it is the struggle for us. Half of the struggle, really, getting to a lake is trying to get a lift off the parents. And if they say no, or if they're busy, then simple as that, I cannot go. There's no other way of me getting there. So yeah, I have to wait until they're free, which is probably another 2 weeks now. I'm looking out there and it looks good for it. It looks, yeah, hopefully it will be like this again in a couple of weeks' time. But yeah, spring is really in the air at the moment. All I can do now is eat my sorrows away with Bombay mix. Get back to a bit of schoolwork. I know I've got my Premier Pro page up here. Yeah, like I said, get on with a bit of schoolwork, and I'm sure it won't be too long until you join me back on the bank again, on the banks of Blue Water. For now though, I'm gonna tuck in to a bit of this. Arriving at the lake, I had a good walk round, finally settling in a swim called the Bird Box on the road bank. With spots found, it was time to get the rods out. And as you can see, it's pretty damn cold. It's very misty in the air. I can barely see out over the lake. But I've just got a text from Dom up the bank, and he's managed to slip one into the net. So we'll head up there and see what he's got in the net. It has been a very quiet night, on the other hand, for me. I'm fishing the deeper water, and the two fish that have come out, both have come to Dom, and he's fishing up near the reeds where it's pretty shallow. So maybe they haven't got into the deep water yet, but we'll stick at it, because there's not really an option to move. So we'll stick at it, and hopefully as it picks up today and gets a bit warmer, they might move in to over there. Let's cross fingers, and I think it's time to put the kettle on, because I'm bloody freezing.
After a freezing cold night, it was evident that the carp had only just started to wake up. Dom's fish had leeches in its mouth, as you can see, a sign the fish haven't been moving much throughout the lake.
New PB?
Easily.
Keep it short. Well, as you've seen, it's been fairly quiet on the fish front all morning, and I've just recast the rods, got the rods back out there, fresh hook baits on. I haven't put any more bait out yet, but I will do later on in the day, and I'll go through all my spod mixes with you as well. So a little more about the lake. It's 8.5 acres, and it used to be a lake where they washed all the gravel, so it's pretty barren out there, to be honest, quite smooth and flat. Pretty deep as well, deep for the water park at least, going down to about 18 foot in places. It does shallow off a bit up to the reeds, and to be honest, at the moment that is where I would be if I were a fish. It's a bit shallower, obviously a bit warmer. It's where the first light hits the water, so it warms up quickest. But I'm gonna reel the rods in a minute, have a walk around, and climb a couple of trees and see if I can see anything. Obviously there's a sort of A team in here as well that I would absolutely love to get my hands on. In particular, one called Three Scale. It is a mid 40, and it is just, it's the first fish really that stood out to me. There's loads of others bigger as well, but it's the first fish that I just really went, I wanna catch that one. So if I had a target, I think it would be that, but in a lake with that's quite hard and with few fish, it might take me a fair few nights before I manage to get that in the net, and I might never, so who knows. Otherwise, like I said, get the rods in, go round, climb a couple of trees, and see if I can spot them.
After a good few laps of the lake, I managed to find fish in two areas. The first in a quiet corner that no one normally fishes much. There was a couple of fish chilling out under the surface. The second was in front of the grid. After climbing the tallest ladder of them all, I saw a good number of fish in front of that swim. This was enough to make me up sticks from the bird box, barrow all my kit round in the midday heat to try and catch one. Evening came round, and it was time to get the rods out. After flicking out the baits carefully, I topped them up with a little bit of bait just to try and tempt a bite. And that bite came when I was least expecting it. It's fair to say, at this point, I was bricking it. With my waders soaked through, I was trembling at the fact that I was hooked in to my first carp from the lake.
Get in!
Well done, fella!
Woo!
Big one?
Scaly one.
Well, I got in the lake and I didn't do my straps on because I was too excited. So my waders are full up, but I couldn't care less.
Get in! Get in!
I'm lost for words.
It's a scaly one.
First fish of my campaign, my Syndicate series. I am over the moon. Now that's what's going. Oh. Right, let's get the rod sorted or do the fish, I'm not too sure yet. I think I need to take a minute. So there we go, my first fish out of the Syndicate. 27 pounds, and as you can see, probably one of the best looking fish I've ever caught in my entire life. I am so, so over the moon to catch this one. I know I say it about pretty much every fish I catch, but this one does mean a lot. I just said before I got this out, this is the closest I've been to the feeling of when I broke my personal best. Absolutely buzzing. Pretty much lost for words. Just look at it. What a fish. Let's swing around, show you the other side, and get her back, because I'm just lost for words. What a wicked fish. White tail. Like I said, we'll get this one back, and I need to get the rod out because maybe there's another one, but if not, I'm really not complaining. Just look at it. That bird's being a bit loud, isn't it? Wicked. Let's get her back.
Put it back. This one's gone. What the hell? I think it's a little one or a tench. Chuck the net. I think it's a tench. Thank you.
went off better than the flipping carp.
Oh. They're all on the spot. Not what we're after. Oh dear, that screamed off. That absolutely screamed off.
Well, I've woken up this morning and it is very overcast and quite chilly. I didn't have anything more throughout the night. After that tench, I think there was a bit too much disturbance in the area. And I think the fish would have pushed off, which kind of ruined the chances for anything more. But I am completely over the moon already with that fish. I'm still buzzing from it, to be honest. And if nothing else happens this session, then I really don't mind. It's the first fish from a syndicate. It's always the hardest one. First fish from any lake's always the hardest one. And it's, for it to be that fish that I've just found out that could be the oldest in the lake, you couldn't have asked for a better first one to start on. Otherwise, we've got one more night left, so I'm just gonna sit back, enjoy it, and maybe have a bit of a social later. Right, so now it's time for a bit of bait talk. These are the baits that I've been using this session. In this bucket is a load of the lovely Cremino. I absolutely love the smell of this bait, and that is partly the reason why I love using it. So it doesn't sink out the car on the way home, and your hands don't smell of very smelly fishy stuff. But yeah, perfect for this time of year in the spring. Breaks down really quickly. You can see in here, each time I give it a squeeze, boilies break down perfectly. To help that process, I have put it in a load of Cremino liquid, a little bit of oil and a little bit of water as well. So it's kind of, at the moment, lying in a bit of slosh, if you wanted to call it that. What I do then is grind some up, crush some up, really easy to do, just in your hands. Put it into another separate bucket, and in here I just add a little bit of sweet corn. You might find that these are different colours. It's because this is a bit more dry, because it is I think it's a day old, because I did it all yesterday and it's been very hot, so it's dried out a bit, so it's a bit darker than all this stuff. But obviously when this gets in the water, it will go this colour again. In here, like I said, big whole boilies of the Cremino, load of crushed Cremino as well, and a little bit of sweet corn. You might find the odd bit of raw marine cutoffs in there as well, but that is my go-to mix for this time of year. You keep getting all the water columns, like it goes up and down with all the oils, and it gets the fish feeding as well. Also, there's quite a few roach in this lake and the coots love to have a bit of a dive. So there will always be bits of items of food for the fish if they turn up.
After getting the rods done with fresh rigs and baits back out on the spots, it was time to embrace my last night. But what I didn't know was how crazy things were about to get.
So we're just prepping to do the photos for Otto's PB, and he's had a bite.
And it feels bigger than what's in there. This has been out since 6 o'clock last night.
Yeah, fine, yeah.
And it's what, 7 o'clock?
Yeah.
That's a flipping tight clutch as well. Jesus. So there we go, 32-4, the second one of this morning's action. Absolutely over the moon. The one in the net that I had in the night was a little bit bigger than this, and a new personal best. Well, I'm absolutely over the moon that both spots are produced. Tactics are working. Now it's just whether I go home today or try and get another night in. Let's flip this one round, get a couple of stills, and we'll show you the bigger one. Absolutely wicked. Spin around and then send her off. So there it is, bit of a lumpy one, but my new personal best, 34 pounds 8 ounces, and pretty angry as well. This was my second fish of the session. Obviously you've just seen the third. Absolutely over the moon, couldn't be more happy on my first session down here. Wicked.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done, mate. Welcome to the Syndicate.
Well, as you've seen, I've had an amazing end to the session. I'm sure if I stayed on another night, I might be able to have a few. I could, but I think it's time to get home now, and I want to end on a high as well. To be honest, it's nice to get into some fresh, clean clothes. not showering for 4 nights isn't the one. But like I said, gonna get home now, sort everything out, and yeah, I'll see you guys next when I'm back on the bank again. Well, you join me here back at home, and the two fish that I caught this morning and the fish a couple of nights ago, I am still on cloud nine about. What a way to end on those two fish this morning with a new personal best. Yeah, absolutely wicked way to start off this little series. Like I said, if you do like this sort of content, there's also my channel, Oak Carp, where it's pretty much the same as what if you just watched me and a camera going around different lakes and yeah, catching a lot of carp. So if you do like it, please head over there. It's called Oak Carp on YouTube. I've got an Instagram as well. And yeah, please subscribe to Baitworks as well. Massive thumbs up if you did like it, and I'd love to hear all your comments as well. But for now, I think I've just packed all away all of my kit. And I do have some schoolwork and some exams looming. So yeah, the camera's gonna be put away for a couple of weeks now, and I am really hoping, yeah, maybe in about a month's time, I'll be able to get back up there, up to blue water, and hopefully have a few more. But like I said, for now, focus on schoolwork, focus on trying to pass my my theory test for my driving license. And hopefully by the next vlog, that I'll be posting on this YouTube channel. Yeah, hopefully by then, exams will be over. The summer will be well and truly underway. And yeah, I will hopefully be going up to blue water and having one of the big girls. So yeah, cross fingers, that's how it all pans out. Massive thank you for watching once again. But for now, I think there's only one thing left for me to do, and that is to go and get a bowl of Bombay mix and head off to bed. Massive thank you for everyone watching. The hell happened there? I think my gimbal just broke.